want to tell you a story. All you have to do is listen.
저명한 기자 출신이었지만 과거 증거가 부족한 상태에서 강행했던 취재로 인해 명예가 실추되었고 현재는 시골 외곽에 위치한 부모님 댁으로 와 미스테리 팟캐스트를 진행하게 된 오늘의 주인공.
웰컴 투 비욘드 벨리버블. The podcast that investigates the unbelievable first-hand accounts of beyond believable. The show that unmasks the mysteries.
어느 날 그녀는 한 익명의 제보자로부터 플로라 메이 킹이라는 여자와 한 벽돌에 관한 제보를 받게 됐는데
Hi, is this Florame King?
Yes. Who is this, please?
I'm a journalist from a podcast called Beyond Believable. I received I guess you call it an anonymous tip-off about a brick.
Is this about Paula's boy? I told him to stop lobbing bricks into that empty house on Hunter's Road.
No. The email wasn't very clear, but they gave me your phone number.
Who gave you my phone number?
As I said, they were anonymous. Is there anything you could tell me about it?
The brick was such a long time ago.
When you say brick, I'm not sure I understand what you mean. Like a house brick or something.
No. It was like nothing I'd ever seen. It changed my life.
How?
These aren't good memories. I shouldn't talk about this. It's a very long time ago, and I don't think
Ms.
I can
King,
help you.
Can I call you Flora May?
I guess.
You said this happened a long time ago. How long ago are we talking?
It's got to be close on 20 years, maybe more.
Can you tell me what your life was like back then?
I worked for a family. Housework, cleaning, looking after their kid. Nice people, but a bit well-to-do. Well, one day I came in to find all this terrible damage to their furniture. Big, awful scratches across everything. The dining table was the worst. It was like somebody was so angry they grabbed the sharpest knife they could find and stabbed at the table, making these big, deep scratches.
Sounds really frightening.
The family thought that my girl Paula had done it. She was only a kid. And she swore black and blue she didn't, but they didn't believe her.
Did you think she did it?
It makes me ashamed. I didn't believe her.
She didn't destroy the furniture. Who did?
Exactly. It caused big trouble in the house. Then the family turned on us, turned on Paula. Then I couldn't do anything to stop it. I couldn't help my little girl, and I was such a terrible mother. And that's when I received the strangest thing. This black brick.
What do you mean, received it? How?
I don't remember.
You don't remember? Can you tell me what the brick was like?
It was darker than anything I've ever seen, and heavy. It was special. As soon as I held it, I felt like something was changing. But then, the couple I was working for, their kid took it from me. And when the husband saw it, he thought he could make some money. He told me it was art. I'll never forgive him for selling it.
He sold it without your permission.
After they decided my Paula ruined their furniture, we had to pay for the damage. So they took the brick as part of the payment. Makes me wild.
Who'd he sell it to?
Some art collector.
Do you remember a name?
Something German. Lang, maybe? Mm. I told the couple that brick was mine. You know, people can't go around selling what's not theirs, can they? But as soon as the family found out I wanted to go to the authorities...
They fired you.
Easy as you please. Years of service gone. I never heard from them again. I never saw the brick again.
What do you think this brick was, Florimé?
I'm not sure. Maybe nothing.
Somebody thought it was interesting enough to email me about. And you say the brick was special, right? What did it make you feel?
Sometimes I think I can still feel it. That power, like something unfinished. Yeah, I thought that there was some kind of power over me. Yeah, it's probably all in my head. Sorry if this is a dead end.
It's okay.
그렇게 인터뷰가 끝나고 그녀는 이 벽돌 이야기에 흥미를 느끼기 시작했습니다. 그리하여 심층 취재를 위해 벽돌을 구매했다던 미술품 수집상 클라우스 랭 씨에게 전화를 걸어보기로 했죠.
Hi, Mr. Lang. I work for a podcast called Beyond Believable. I came across a story about a black brick that you bought from an Australian man many years ago. And I just want to corroborate a few details with you. So you're telling me this object really exists?
Yes, yes. In fact, I have several.
What do you mean, several?
When I was a very young man, I also received a brick.
So you're saying there's more than one of these objects out there?
I know of at least a dozen around the world, of which I have a few. Each exactly the same. Most peculiar, very collectible.
And how did you receive your brick, Mr. Lang?
It was just there, in my house.
Can you describe these bricks?
They're black, about the size of a gold bar, but darker than any other object I have seen. Very heavy, not man-made, but not natural either.
이 벽돌에 호기심이 생겼던 랭 씨는 지인에게 3D 스캔을 의뢰했었습니다.
And?
I have never seen anything like it. The interior of each brick is filled with hundreds of symbols folded into each other.
Can you send me these scans?
It was years ago.
물론 증거는 갖고 있지 않은 상태.
And these symbols, what alphabet is it? Latin, Arabic, Cyrillic, hieroglyphic?
Each brick has its own unique set of symbols. But in mine, I see a symbol that reminds me of a scar that I have had since I was a small boy. It makes me think this brick is speaking directly to me.
랭 씨는 벽돌을 받기 전
What do you mean?
꿈인지 현실인지 경계가 모호했던 기이한 경험을 한 적이 있었죠.
This awful creature appeared in my bathroom.
Sorry, did you say a creature?
It was a man, but grotesque. Awful. A face like wet bread. And it was most extraordinary, but somehow I knew this creature was my brother.
How?
A feeling. It was connected to me and I to it. My brother was a teenager when he died. He had a bad heart. And that creature in my bathtub watching me, telling me what I have always known.
Which is?
A part of me wanted him to die. He was so clever and strong and loved, I could never compete. But when he died, I felt happy, relieved. And after this terrible vision, that's when I received the brick.
랭 씨는 그 경험을 한 뒤로 벽돌을 치워버렸지만 여전히 그 으스스했던 기운은 떨쳐내지 못하고 있었습니다.
What makes you think you're not crazy, Mr. Lang?
You're right, yeah. A madman never thinks he's mad. But I am normally a very straight-ahead kind of guy. No drink, no drugs. I like reality very much.
And you think this vision is connected to the break?
I'm certain of it.
마지막으로 랭시는 이 벽돌의 출처를
You don't believe me.
외계의 물건이라 확신하고 있었죠.
I really am quite busy, so if you have nothing else you need...
Yes, thank you. Thank you for your time, Mr. Lang.
Guten Tag.
하지만 아무리 미스테리 전문 팟캐스트라 하더라도 명색이 전직 기자였는데 아무런 팩트도 없이 증언만으로 이 허무맹랑한 이야기를 믿을 수는 없었습니다.
Sometimes I think I can still feel it. That power, like something unfinished. Yeah, it's probably all in my head.
게다가 이번에도 자칫 실수라도 하는 날이면
Yeah, it's probably all in my head.
영원히 이 업계에서 발도 못 붙이게 될 것이 불보듯 뻔했죠.
I can't explain it. I don't know. Yeah, this was 20 years ago.
하지만 반대로 생각했을 때 이 벽돌 이야기를 잘만 요리한다면 자신의 커리어를 다시 끌어올려줄 만한 소재임은 분명했습니다.
Something unfinished. Some kind of power over me. Something unfinished. Some kind of power over me.
As I listened to Florime and Klaus describe their experiences with these powerful dark objects, I feel a kind of terror creep over me. Who sent this anonymous email, and what do they want me to find? Florime's words haunt me, an object filled with unknowable power. What do these bricks want from us? To solve this mystery, I need your help, listeners. I want to know, is there anyone out there that knows anything, anything at all about these bricks? And can we uncover the dark forces behind them before it's too late?
결국 그녀는 악마의 편집을 거친 뒤 이 방송을 대중들에게 선보이기로 결정하였죠. 대중의 반응은 그야말로 폭발적이었습니다. 국장인 타일러는 초흥분 상태였고 그 벽돌에 관한 제보도 연달아 들어오고 있었죠.
Are you saying you also have one of these objects?
Yes, ma'am. I received it 2 years ago.
And you don't know Florime or Klaus Lang?
Well, never heard of them. But when I listened to your podcast, I thought, Laura Sully, that's that damn rock.
그중 한 제보자는 2년 전 원인을 알 수 없는 병으로 매우 아팠었는데 그녀 역시 이전 제보자들과 똑같은 증상을 겪었었습니다.
You also get visions?
Yes, ma'am. I call it hijacking. It feels violent, invasive.
And what do you see?
특이점이 있다면 제보자는 그 환영액에서 독특한 냄새를 맡았었다는 것이었죠.
What kind of smell?
Best way you can describe it is rotting meat, like old rancid meat left out in the sun.
Do you still have it?
It's sitting right in front of me.
Could you send me a photograph of it?
그리고 수확이 있었다면
I don't see why not.
이 제보자를 통해 벽돌의 실물 사진을 받아볼 수 있었다는 것이었습니다. 하지만 그게 전부였죠. 제보는 여기저기서 들어오고 있었지만 실질적으로 제보를 뒷받침해줄 만한 증거들은 턱없이 부족했을 뿐더러
How did you find it?
What do you mean?
Well, you say you received it, but how? Did it just turn up one day? Was it in a package or something?
Look, I can't tell you that. It was there. That's all.
다들 그 벽돌을 받았다고만 할 뿐 어떻게 받았는지에 대해선 아무도 확실히 말해주지 못했습니다.
The man in Boston received this black rock. The operation manager in Dubai.
My father believed the stone was an omen sent from the dead. To tell me how he got it.
We are all scared that we will get one next. But why?
아니, 되려 점점 더 영양가 없는 가짜 소스들만 들어오고 있었고 그녀의 취재는 점점 더 미궁 속으로 빠져들기 시작했죠. 그러던 도중 자신의 할아버지도 비슷한 일을 경험했다는 제보자가 나타났는데.
You said your grandfather's brick has disappeared.
I told you it's gone. And ever since, he's different.
Different how?
There's nothing behind his eyes. No soul.
Right.
And now my father had been getting sick. The same sick as my grandfather. He won't eat, can't work. I am so scared he's going to receive this object as well.
Is he also getting visions?
Yes. He is terrified. He knows what is coming. I could be next. Any of us could be next. It is spreading like a disease or an invasion. This is why it is dangerous to keep doing the podcast. Don't you understand?
제보자는 제보로만 그치지 않고
I am warning you. You have to stop what you're doing. You are in danger. What if the break comes after you?
I really don't think.
Please. End this now. That is all I am asking.
그녀가 하고 있는 일이 얼마나 위험한지에 대해 섬뜩한 경고를 날려주었습니다. 재밌는 건 그 다음이었죠. 잊고 지냈던 수집가 랭시에게 문자가 온 것이었는데 바로 일전에 이야기했던 벽돌의 3D 스캔본을 찾았다는 것. 그리고 랭시가 이야기했던 대로 벽돌 내부는 알 수 없는 상형 문자들로 가득했습니다. 그녀는 즉각 자신의 지인이자 언어학자인 스콧에게 자문을 구해보기로 했죠.
What do you think?
하지만 그건 스콧에게도
It's not a language I recognize.
And?
생소한 문자.
Linguistically speaking, they're quite unique.
But?
It could be some sort of complex semantographic alphabet. But it feels untethered from any language I know of.
Like a completely unknown language?
Not quite.
그런데 스콧은 그녀의 취재를 진지하게 받아들이지 않았습니다.
You know how much I respect you. But all I'm saying, do you really believe this? Or do you just want to believe it?
그는 그저 망상증 환자들에게 그녀가 놀아나고 있는 것은 아닐까 걱정하고 있었죠. 하지만 그렇다고 치부하기엔 그날 밤 그녀가 겪은 일은 너무나도 섬뜩한 일이었습니다. 누군가 그녀의 현관 앞에 낯선 택배 상자 하나를 놓고 갔던 것. 제보로만 들었던 일이 자신에게 벌어진 것은 아닐까 걱정됐던 그녀.
Jesus Christ.
하지만 상자 안에 들어있던 건 검정 벽돌이 아닌 USB였죠. 그 USB 안에 들어있던 건 다름 아닌 그녀의 9살 생일 파티 영상이었습니다. 그런데 어린 시절 자신이 검은 벽돌을 선물 받았었다는 충격적인 사실을 접하게 된 그녀.
Hi, I'm unavailable right now. Just leave a message and I'll get back to you.
Dad, someone just left a package at the door and there was a video. I'm just really confused. Can you just call me when you get this, please?
더욱 소름 돋았던 것은 상자 안에 들어있던 완충제들엔 각기 다른 칠이 더해져 있었는데 그림에 맞게 완충제들을 조합해보자. 검은 벽돌에서 발견했던 그 상형 문자의 모양이 나와버린 것이었죠. 그녀는 이것을 랭이 버린 돈 없은 장난이라고 생각했습니다.
아, the podcaster. Why are you ringing me, please? What's happening? You seem very upset.
Yes, I'm very upset. I want to know why I just received a symbol from your volumetric scan in a fucking package. Accompanying a video of me as a 9-year-old where I say I received a black brick, which makes me think you're fucking around, trying to spook me for some reason.
I don't know what you're talking about, a symbol. You have a brick.
You can't do this to me. I will call the cops. I will ruin your gallery.
I'm doing nothing. I'm at the playground with my grandchildren. Please listen, I really don't know what you're talking about. I'm telling you the truth. I have no reason to lie to you.
하지만 랭이 말처럼 그가 이런 장난을 칠 이유가 없었죠. 다만 랭이 말을 믿기 위해선 그의 이전 증언들을 검증해 볼 필요는 있었습니다.
Class, I want you to show me the brick. Proof to me they're real.
Give me 30 minutes.
그리고 잠시 후 랭에게 걸려온 전화.
클라우스, what the fuck took you so long?
I'm here in my vault.
Just wait.
I haven't seen the brick for so long. It looks how I remember.
Hold on, I need to record this. You said you had a few bricks. You've got dozens.
Spent my life collecting, trying to understand, but none of it matters now. My brother is here.
그런데 심상치 않은 랭의 상태.
What? Klaus, I can't see. You need to show me what is happening.
Please, stop.
What are you doing?
It has to end.
Klaus, can you hear me? Pick up the phone.
(웃음) 그 소름 돋는 통화가 랭의 마지막 목소리였습니다. Please leave a message. 동시에 그 생생한 현장음은 대중들을 상대로 어그로를 끌기에 너무나도 훌륭한 재료였죠.
I can sense him. He's here. It's a sound all I can hear. It's a sound.
Welcome to Beyond Believable. I believe my life is in danger.
What is this, Rockman? What does he want?
Trying to understand, but none of that matters now.
What happened in Klaus Lang's art vault? And was I the last person to speak to him alive? I have to continue this podcast. I have to find the truth. Something terrible is coming. Something.
But it was me. It chose.
Unbelievable.
역시나 반응은 폭발적. 문제는 무슨 이유에서인지 날이 갈수록 그녀의 몸 상태가 최악으로 치닫고 있었다는 점이었죠. 물론 고통을 잊게 해주는 콘텐츠의 대흥행 덕분에 그녀는 버틸 수가 있었습니다.
I'm not gonna stop, Scott.
This is finally a real story. I've got good numbers and people are really listening.
Yeah, look, I get that, but...
There is something going on. You know, I feel like this story could be career-defining.
It's not that. I'm just...
What, you just think this story is bullshit? Huh?
Well...
You're right from the start. You hated this podcast, right? Why do you always do this?
That's unfair. I'm just worried about you.
Well, I don't need your fucking sympathy. I need your support.
I am trying to, but you're making it really bloody hard. Look, all these symbols and videos in the middle of the night, have you ever thought it might be someone with a grudge trying to mess with you?
스콧의 조언을 대수롭지 않게 생각했지만
I didn't see how.
순간 그녀의 머리를 스쳐 지나간 것이 하나 있었죠. 바로 이번 취재의 시발점이라 할 수 있는 익명의 제보자가 보낸 진실은 밝혀질 것이다 라는 문구가 그것. 그 문구는 보통 원한이 있는 자가 복수하고 싶은 대상에게 보내는 경고 메시지로 알려져 있었죠.
Matter cannot be hid long. A man's son may, but in the end, the truth will.
What do you mean, darling?
I got it on brick. It's really pretty.
I received pretty brick. Wow. The birthday.
잠시 후 생일 파티 영상을 다시 유심히 돌려보던 그녀는 이내 충격적인 장면을 목격하게 됩니다. 바로 그 생일 파티를 촬영한 사람이. 첫 익명의 제보자가 연락처를 알려준 플로라 메이 킹이었던 것. 그 말은 곧 과거 그녀의 집에서 일하다가 쫓겨난 가사도우미였던 플로라 메이가 그녀를 엿먹이기 위해 이번 일을 꾸몄다는 얘기였죠.
Did you know you work for my family when we spoke? What? Did you? No. I don't want to talk to you. I heard your podcast. I didn't say those things like that. You changed what I meant to say. What is this, some sort of fucking revenge plot? Payback for my family taking the brick. Of course you. You're the daughter. I'm the daughter, Jesus. You sent me the email. The truth will out. Your FK Flora May King. You wanted me to find you. What? You sent me the video. What video? The video of my fucking birthday. What other video am I talking about?
Harassing my mother. Is this some kind of sick joke? Your family is the one harassing me over something that happened
20 years ago over a fucking brick.
Why are you calling
you
us?
You can't get away with this.
Get away with what exactly?
Emails, videos, terrorizing me.
What are you talking about?
You made me look like an idiot. It's pathetic. And if you don't stop harassing me, I'm gonna call the cops.
Be my guest. You're the people who stole our property.
Oh, you want an apology? Is that what you want?
No.
이어서 밝혀지는 그날의 진실.
You told your parents a lie. All those years ago, it changed my life.
What are you talking about?
Even Mum thought I'd done it. She just stood back and let your family take everything.
Paul, I really don't know what you're talking about.
You sabotaged my life.
What?
As soon as your parents paid for that scholarship, you hated me. You were jealous, scared. I was better than you, and your parents liked me. You couldn't stand fighting for their attention. You wanted to be special.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You do.
그날 가구를 긁었던 건 플로라 메이의 딸 폴라가 아니었습니다. 다만 확실한 건 그것을 폴라에게 뒤집어 씌웠던 사람은 그녀였다는 것이었죠. 다만 그녀가 기억을 못하고 있었을 뿐.
Don't call here again.
정확한 사실 확인을 위해선 당시 현장의 산 증인이라 할 수 있는 아빠의 말을 들어볼 필요가 있었습니다.
Hey, sweetie, I got your message. What on earth are you talking about? A video?
This spoke to Floramir. I know you stole the brick.
What brick?
The black brick when I was a kid. Tell me the truth.
Darling, look, it was a long time ago. It doesn't matter. That brick was some art thing. The woman didn't know what she had in her hands.
So you stole it.
We didn't steal anything. She was our employee. She found it on our property. And then on your birthday, you picked it up and thought it was yours. A present. And you weren't wrong. It was ours.
You fired her, Dad.
Furniture, if that's not a fireable offense, I don't know what is.
How do you know it was her?
Well, you told us, sweetie. You're probably too young to remember. Floramay's kid was a nightmare. As soon as we saw what she'd done to the furniture, we called the police.
Police? She was just a kid. What did the cops do?
They charged her with property damage. But because she was so young, it was a slap on the wrist, really. If she and her mother had to pay us back for the damage done to the furniture, and they didn't have any money, of course. So when the brick came along,
they took it.
It was the only object of value they had.
All of this over some furniture.
하지만 아빠는 잘못 알고 있었죠. 그날 식탁을 칼로 긁었던 사람은 바로 아빠의 딸이었다는 걸. 게다가 식탁에 새겼던 상형문자의 모양은 플로라 메이가 소유했던 벽돌의 스캔본과 동일했습니다. 그녀는 이번 이슈의 결정적인 증언이자 자신의 커리어를 끝장낼 수도 있는 아빠의 녹음본을 세상에서 영원히 감춰두기로 결심하게 됩니다. 그러자 갑자기 복부에서 찢어지는 듯한 통증을 느끼기 시작한 그녀. 즉시 화장실로 달려가 목구멍으로 넘어오는 이물감을 개어내기 시작했는데 문제는 뱉어낸 그것이 그녀가 지금껏 취재해왔던 검은 벽돌이라는 것이었습니다. 말로만 듣던 그 일이 자신에게도 일어날지는 꿈에도 몰랐던 그녀. 이어서 그녀는 그간 제보자들이 했던 실수를 반복하지 않기로 합니다. 더 큰 위협이 찾아오기 전에 그 벽돌을 부수기로 한 것이었죠. 그렇게 한바탕 한 후 거실에서 잠시 숨을 고르고 있던 그녀. 그런데 방금 벽돌을 부쉈던 화장실에서 누군가의 인기척이 느껴져 왔습니다. 조심스럽게 화장실로 가보자. 부서진 벽돌은 온데간데 없이 사라지고 자신과 똑 닮은 여자가 서 있었죠. 아직 그것의 의중을 파악할 수 없었던 그녀. 본능적으로 그녀는 몸에 지니고 있던 기자 정신을 살려 그것을 인터뷰 해보기로 합니다. 이건 특종을 넘어서 지구 역사에 길이 남을 인터뷰가 될 것이 분명했기 때문이었죠.
무엇이세요? I want to know why you're here and what you want from me. Promise.
그런데 그것의 그녀를 향한 대답은 간단 명료하면서도 무척이나 위협적이었습니다. 그렇다면 살 길은 하나뿐. 드디어 그녀의 시신을 처리하고 돌아온 그것은 집으로 돌아와 많은 사람들이 기다리고 있을 비욘드 빌리버블의 신규 콘텐츠를 이어나가기 시작했습니다.
I want to tell you a story. You might not believe it, but that doesn't mean it isn't true. I need to tell it anyway. I have a secret.
I'm the only one who can share it. The only one who is willing. And when I tell this story, I will change everything. All you have to do is listen.
영화 모놀리스는 저예산 공포영화가 걸어가야 할 길을 명확하게 제시한 듯 보입니다. 사진과 녹화 영상을 제외하면 거의 1인극에 가까운 영화 모놀리스는 등장인물이 한 명일지라도 그 공백감이 느껴지지 않을 정도로 긴장감이 꽉 차있는 영화였습니다. 외계인과 관련된 음모론이 등장하고 충격적인 결말에 다다르기 전까지 관객과 주인공 모두 그 음모론에 대한 의심과 믿음을 반복하게 되는데요. 절대로 신뢰할 수 없는 제보자의 증언들이 이어지지만 시간이 흐름에 따라 그것들이 겹겹이 쌓이며 진실로 변해가는 과정은 몰락한 기자역을 맡은 릴리 설리번의 감정 변화와 맞물려 믿을 수 없는 흡입력으로 치환되게 됩니다. 결말부, 외계인이 자신의 정체를 밝히려는 것인지 그녀가 자신의 추악한 과거를 고백하려는 것인지 모호하게 끝난 열린 결말 역시 개인적으로 너무나도 마음에 들었고요. 으스스하게 표현한 제보자들의 썰과 블루톤으로 일관된 영화의 질감 등은 시종일관 차가운 에너지 가득한 영화의 분위기를 한껏 높여주었다고 생각됩니다. 더불어 SF 스릴러계의 전설 엑스파일의 배경음이 나와도 이상하지 않을 정도로 고전적인 분위기가 두드러져서 그 시절 그 감성을 좋아하시는 분들께는 안성맞춤인 영화라고 생각됩니다. 이상 헬무비였고요. 저는 다음 영상에서 찾아뵙도록 하겠습니다.